Alright, so in the previous tutorials what we have seen is how you can initialize a composer, how you can install your dependencies, first dependency, how you install and segregate different dependencies based on your development environment and live environment. Now let's just go and understand how we can autoload our custom functionalities or custom PHP files or folders or namespaces. So we are going to go one by one in this. Let's just talk about files in this lecture. So if you remember, as I suggested, composer's vendor autoload.php is entirely managing the autoloading for you. So now you would imagine, for example, if I create a file, let's call it helpers.php. PHP. Let's just create a class. I'm calling it public static function. SL, which will be string length. Just a random function here, just to demonstrate. What I'm going to do is return strlen. String, so it will be returning the length of the string which we pass in here. Okay, now what you would imagine is, as I suggested, autoload.php is managing all the autoloading for you, so you do not need to require this file, you can directly use it here. So let's just see if it works. Helpers SL, and let's just pass my name in here. Ideally it should output 5, which is length of the string in here, but if I go back and see, it will say class helpers not found. So you would think that I always said autoload.php is managing this internally for you, then why it is not, you know, finding this class? One of the simplest answer of this is composer has an internal structure of internal, you can say, a record of what it needs to autoload. So all these packages which are inside vendor are recorded inside that autoloader's files, composer internal files. But helpers.php is a new class which has been created, but we have not yet explained composer or not yet specified composer that we need to actually start, you know, autoloading this class. So how we can do that? It's really, really simple. Composer comes with a property called as autoload. You can use variety of autoloading concepts in here. What we are currently doing is we are trying to autoload just one file. So for that we write files. It takes array, it's not taking an JSON object, it takes an array, and we specify helpers.php. Actually the file or path to that file, where that file is located. I save this. Once I save this, let me just go back and refresh this. You would think that this will work, but definitely it will not. It will just still say helpers class not found, and the reason is being we have updated the composer.json. But if you remember, whenever we update anything in composer.json, we need to dump that autoload files into the references composer has internally. So what we'll do is composer dump autoload. You can do this or you can do directly like this. I prefer this way. So once I am dumping this autoload, what composer is internally doing is composer is actually, you know, referencing this autoload somewhere. Okay, so first of all, let's just go back and see if it works. It does. Now it works. So you would think, how is composer managing it internally? One of the simplest answer is inside vendor composer, we have all the autoload files in here. So now what we have done, we have autoloaded files. So let's just go inside vendor composer and let's just go autoload underscore files.php. It has internally a simple, it returns a simple array, a registered simple array of what we have, you know, mentioned in the composer.json. What we have done is we have mentioned composers autoload helper.php file. If you come here, you will see auto underscore files inside vendor folders composer folder. It registers helper file, and as I suggested, it takes and manages the base dir directly. So base dir means actually the root of your folder, and it will load this helpers.php inside it. So whatever you do in this, for example, I am writing new public static function get time, return time, just returning a timestamp just for demonstration purposes. Now I go back and I change this to get time, go to the browser and refresh, and we have this. So it simply means that you just need to create a class right in here, auto load files, and you dump auto load so that it generates the auto load files, and internally it registers here inside an array, and then you are ready to go. So whatever functions you do or whatever function you add and remove in here, you do not need to dump anything or you do not need to fire any command. It's just specific to the class, but whatever functions you write in there after the dump has been done are nothing to do with composer. So now let's just come back and write another file, and create another file inside vendor. Let's just inside the folder, actually it's a new file called as let's say the file class names, or let me do one thing, let me just create a simple public function, a helper function, instead of a class and encapsulating inside a class. So I need to write a function, let's say get current mood. Okay, so function get current mood. I want to return I am happy today because I am learning composer auto loading. Aren't you happy? Yes, you would. So now I am writing this function, but there is an important step to first check if it function exists. So PHP has a simple function, if function exists, function name which takes in a string. So what we need to check is if it does not exist. So I'm writing say not. So what it says is if function is not, you know, there, it does not exist, then we register this function. And I'm going to say this as functions.php. If you understand, this is not actually encapsulated, or I mean there is no MVC here, it's just a open function, not encapsulated in any kind of class or any kind of hierarchy. Now I go to index.php and let me just call that function. So it's get current mood, and if I go back and refresh, it's going to say class not function not found. You would say simple reason that we have not registered that file. So if you want to register a second file, you can just say functions.php, and you notice in here it the autoloads underscore php files, which is actually composer's php reference file, just has this helpers.php. now we have added this in composer, let's just dump autoload files. Okay, it contains okay the extra comma in here. Okay, now let's just do dump autoload again. It says generating autoloading files. Now if we go back, composer has added that reference in here, the return array which it has inside vendor composer autoload files.php, its internal php reference file. And now autoload.php is ready to autoload this function, which is actually inside this file functions.php for you. So if we go back and refresh, we have this. So it's really easy to use these files, autoload files. But one of the major questions which comes to your mind is, what if I have a kind of package, a custom package, which has, let's say, 50 to 60 files. So do I need to do I need to mention all the files in here? The answer is no. Composer comes with a PSR standard autoloading, which we are going to cover in the next lecture. So stay tuned. Thanks for your time and thanks for watching. Happy coding.